Hey everybody, John at Freshwater Systems here, and we're going through our series of answering frequently asked questions. Today's topic, water softeners. What are water softeners? A water softener addresses one of the biggest water problems that we have, and that's hard water. Hard water is made up of primarily calcium and magnesium mineral that cause all kinds of nuisance in the house. They clog plumbing. They create scale on your shower head and that filmy scum that gets on the shower curtain or the shower doors. It also beats up hot water appliances. The hot water heater, that scale will get on the heating elements. And if you're in hard water territory, sometimes it sounds like the hot water heater's making popcorn because the scale has attached itself to the heating element. And as it heats up and expands, that rock that's now crusted on the heating elements is popping and cracking and moving. It also does just nasty things to your dishwasher. So a water softener is an appliance that uses ion exchange to remove those hardness-causing minerals so you just absolutely eliminate all of those kind of problems. The primary components of a water softener are the mineral tank where the resin is, the control valve which tells it when to regenerate. It's also counting how much water goes through it because these are demand initiated controllers. That enables this unit to be very efficient. And next to the mineral tank is the brine tank, which is where the salt goes. The salt mixes with the water on the bottom, and when a system needs to regenerate, it's going to draw that heavy brine solution out of the tank and run it through the resin. Some softeners use a process called co-current brining, which means that the brine goes down through the resin bed in the same direction as the service flow. The softener we sell is a high efficiency unit, and the brine flow is actually counter-current, or it goes the opposite direction up through the resin bed. The benefit and the efficiency gain from that is when the brine's going down, it's releasing those hardness minerals that are going down the depth of the bed and they're getting exchanged again in resin that hadn't been exchanged in the first place. So you have to use more water, you have to use a little more salt to get the complete regeneration cycle. Countercurrent brining means that the brine solution runs up the bed so that you're dealing with just the exchange sites and not having to re-exchange resin that just got re-exchanged in the exchange process. So it saves a lot of salt, saves a lot of water. That's countercurrent brining, and when you look for a water softener, that's a feature you want to have. But that's the basic components of a water softener. How do water softeners work? Water softeners work on a principle called ion exchange. And it's a tank full of resin that looks like that, and each one of these little beads is charged with a sodium ion. Hardness minerals, as it flows through this tank, they're in an ionic form, and they will be attracted to these resin beads, and the resin bead will grab a hold of them and let loose the sodium ion. So as the water flows through this column of resin, it's removing all of that hardness mineral. What do water softeners remove? Water softeners remove hardness-causing minerals. That's calcium, that's magnesium. It also will attract and hold on to any positively charged ion, and that could include things like iron. Iron is a stainer. It's an annoyance type of thing. If you've got iron in your water, you know it because you've got stains. You've got stains in your toilet, you've got stains in your sinks and tubs, and a water softener can actually grab that iron as well. Now the iron has to be in solution, which means if you hold a glass up, you can't see any iron in there. It'll grab a hold of that iron as well. So anything that's in the cation family can be removed by a water softener. Are water softeners necessary? Water softeners are necessary because they remove damaging hard water causing minerals from the water supply. Things like your dishwasher, your shower, your laundry, any hot water using appliance in your home gets beat up by hard water. It creates scale, makes them harder to work. Heating elements don't work quite as well. And there's a great benefit to taking showers or using soft water to bathe and clean with. You don't have to deal with scale, soap scum, and a lot of other nuisance type problems that hard water creates. So the quick answer to are water softeners necessary? If you've got hard water, you bet it is. Are water softeners safe? The question about water softeners being safe refers directly to the amount of sodium that softeners will reintroduce to the water supply. In the ion exchange process, the resin beads are grabbing a hold of those hardness-causing minerals and they're releasing sodium ions back into the water stream that's going into your house. It's not as much as people think. For example, if you have moderately hard water, say 5 grains per gallon, it's going to add 37 milligrams of sodium per quart of water. Well, that doesn't seem to be very much, especially when you compare that 2 slices of bacon, for example, is 150 milligrams of sodium. The amount of sodium added is directly linear to the amount of hardness minerals being reduced. So in that ion exchange process, for every milligram of hardness, it's going to release 2 milligrams of sodium. But it's not that much. If you have extremely hard water, and let's say you have a doctor telling you, hey, lay off the sodium, it would be beneficial for you to add, say, a reverse osmosis system for the water that you drink and cook with, which is not only going to take care of the sodium the softener adds, but it's also going to take out any sodium that might naturally be there in the first place. What is a salt-free water softener? A salt-free water softener doesn't exist. A process that's not ion exchange, but it uses a media that creates little microcrystals that actually wrap around the hardness-causing minerals so that they don't come out and create scale. We sell a product called ScaleNet that does that. It's not a traditional salt-regenerating water softener, but it's an anti-scale device. And it works by keeping the hardness minerals from coming out of solution and creating scale on products. But it's not a water softener. It doesn't give you the same benefits that removing the mineral, which is what a water softener does, it doesn't give you the same benefits. So you don't get to save your detergent amounts. You don't get to have really nice, brighter laundry because the minerals are still there. Can water softeners leak? And what do I do if they do leak? Water softeners can leak. And just like any other water-using appliance, a lot of that happens during the installation or service time. Depending upon your maintenance, it's possible that you can move something or jostle a fitting that would cause it to leak. But leaks really occur primarily at the point of installation. So taking your time to make sure that your threads are well done, that if you're using push to connects, that they are seated properly. And normal wear and tear, the water softener or those types of appliances shouldn't leak. But leaks can happen. If you bump into the appliance and you jostle it and it pulls a fitting apart, those kind of things can happen. So to prevent it, make sure you install the product in a place where it's not very likely that something's going to bump into it or move it. If you're in if you're in an earthquake part of the country, you might want to strap it so that if the house moves, it's going to stay standing up and not fall over, tearing plumbing up. How do you install a water softener? The best way to install a water softener is to locate it where you're treating or softening all the water that's going into the house. It's beneficial, especially for the hot water side, because hardness is the worst on the hot water side. It'll destroy your hot water tank. It'll destroy the dishwasher, and things like your shower head will get all clogged up. So we want to make sure that the location of the water softener is treating especially the hot water, but all the water going into the house. Most softeners have a bypass built into the inlet and the outlet. So you, by turning a valve, you're able to bypass the softener in case you have to provide some kind of maintenance to it, or even while you're working on it, to put it in. Now, if the softener you choose does not have a bypass, it's a great idea to actually build one out of plumbing to bypass the equipment for that very reason in case you have to maintain the unit. Do water softeners need to be replaced or repaired? Water softeners needing replacement or repair, it's possible, but can be avoided if you properly maintain the system. If you make sure the softener never runs out of salt, make sure that if you have iron or manganese in the water supply, that you're taking steps to protect the resin from those elements. There's resin cleaners on the market that adding to the regeneration process will help relieve the resin beads of those kind of things. Iron and manganese can actually embed themselves and eventually foul the resin to where it won't function as an ion exchanger anymore. That would require you to replace the resin bed. So if you take care of the resin, don't let it run out of salt, always maintain it as best you can, resin could quite frankly last anywhere from 18 to 25 years. In fact, I've seen homeowners on really hard water still 30 years down the road from the installation, and that dude was still working like a charm. So resins and water softeners can last a good long time, many years, if they're properly maintained. Now, you still might have to perform service once in a while. A good rule of thumb I always like is to put a sediment filter in front of the appliances to help keep the screens and the injectors that are inside that control valve from getting clogged up. Well, there was some of the most frequently asked questions that we get about water softeners. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you got something out of it. If you've got other questions, give us a call or visit our website at www.freshwatersystems.com.